रिगार्डिंग द कोविड रिलेटेड वॉट रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स आणि येते त्याच्या संदर्भात, आणि द सेकंड इज आमचे रेव्हेन्यू मिनिस्टर्स अचीवमेंट, डिफरंट रिफॉर्म्स जे आम्ही रेव्हेन्यू मिनिस्ट्री असतली, लेबर मिनिस्ट्री असतली, आयटी मिनिस्ट्री असतली, जे जे रिफॉर्म्स वेगवेगळे अचीवमेंट्स जो केल्या ते तुमकां एक्सप्लेन करपा खातीर आसा. तर फर्स्ट आय लास्क रेव्हेन्यू मिनिस्टर मॅडम जेनिफर, शी वील एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द रेव्हेन्यू लेबर अँड आय टी डिपार्टमेंट. And then in details, Revenue Secretary Sanjay Kumar will explain you in detail.
Good evening, everybody. I think this is the first press conference we're having in regards to my departments. So I would like to highlight a few achievements that we have been able to do during my term. So we'll start with labor and employment first. I will start with the job fair, actually, which was conducted in Talegaon first. It was conducted on 19th of October 2019, where we had the participation of 60 employers, companies that participated. They advertised for 2,900 vacancies, were made available, actually, and a total of candidates who came for the job fair were 4,313. Who registered, and about 880 provisional offer letters were given. So that was our first achievement when it came to job fair. Then the second one that we organized was the Swayampurna Yuva, which was keeping in tune with CM's vision of Swayampurna Goya. So the department organized a career guidance, skill development and employment fair program by the name of Swayampurna Yuva on 27th of October 2021 at DM College Complex Mapsa, and there was subsequently another one also on the 30th of October at GVM College in Ponda, where we had about 73 companies who participated, and 4,265 candidates registered there, and about 1,586 vacancies were made available, and 700 candidates were shortlisted. The next was we had four orientation sessions on civil service competitive exams, that is the UPSC and the GPSC, for graduate students who were pursuing at our Model Career Center. And as you all know, the Model Career Center also was launched on 15th October 2020 at Shram Shakti Bhavan in Panjim. Now it's a state-of-the-art center, which has a capacity of seating capacity of 80. We have a training hall, audio visual video conferencing, and an independent counseling room. We have also signed a contract with CII for a year. So with CII was given the task of having different activities. So they had about 67 independent activities at the Model Career Center, which included job meet drives, workshops, soft skill training, sessions on civil service, competitive exams, entrepreneurship programs, and a lot more. So a total of 547 candidates were placed with offer letters as of November 2021 with the help of CII at the Model Career Center. And we have, the next is the Citizen Service Center at MAPSA, which was launched on 20th October 2020. And we had a few citizen service centers which were already running, which were renovated during this time. Then the one-time benefit of 4,000 per worker was granted and dispersed on 7th 4 2020 under the Goa Welfare Board. It was an amount of 91,92,000 were dispersed to 2,298 workers as a one-time benefit during the COVID period. And 58 personnel under the CCP, that was the supervisors, sweepers, drivers, etc., who were daily wage workers from the year 2001 to 2005, were given permanent jobs after signing an MOU between the Department of Labour and CCP, which was done on 19th of Feb 2020. Then we also launched the Labour Smart Card on 24th of May 2021. And till date, the department has gathered data from over 950 companies and 39,000 employees. So this is a smart card which carries all the information about each employee. So if an employee is working in a particular company and he decides to leave, everything he has to update all the details on the card, and it will be readily available to the next employer. Currently also we launched a labor and employment portal, that's www.labor.gov.in in 2019, and that was also integrated with the employment exchange and relaunched in 2020 because it was integrated with the employment exchange. The portal was specially launched for registration of employees via the labor and employment department. And currently we have a total of 1,46,133 registered individuals on the employment exchange portal. Then the ESIC also has taken over the functioning of the hospital in Margao and was implemented on 6th of January 2020. So during the pandemic and the COVID-19 for March 2020, ESIC hospital was one of the first hospitals which was requisitioned as a COVID care hospital. An implementation of COVID-19 relief schemes under ESIC by Government of India, which states that in an event of an unfortunate death of a worker covered under ESIC Act 1948, 90% of the average wages of the deceased will be distributed among eligible dependent family members, and every month and paid directly to their bank account. The spouse of the deceased is also eligible for medical care on a nomination contribution of 120 per year. So the beneficiary of this scheme were about 55. Then the ESIC dispensary Panjim won the best ESIC dispensary in the medical category award by Employees State Insurance Corporation of India. Then we also made amendments to the Shops and Establishment Act and notified it on the 24th of 2021. The amendments were made keeping in mind the digitization and the EOBD, thereby making provisions for online registration, auto-renewal and auto-generation of registration certificates. The amendment also allows for paid maternity leave for 26 weeks. It makes provisions for protection and transportation of women from workplace to their residence in case of odd working hours. The department has also added 24 services of the labor and employment on Goa Online. There are different services which are self-certification scheme, amendment to license for contract, notification of vacancies, amendment to shop and establishments, etc. So this is my labor and employment department. Okay, now we come to the IT department. So the key initiatives and achievements of IT department from July 2019 to November 2021. Under the e-district, that's Goa Online, we have added a total of 64 services across 18 departments. Currently, 157 services from 25 departments are live. We have 6.25 lakh unique registered users and a total of 20.12 transactions which are going on Goa Online till date. Then we also launched Know Your Scheme, a service for eligibility and verification of government schemes. Also keeping in mind that lots of people didn't know what schemes were available. So under the guidance of CM, this Know Your Scheme was a very important step for us towards making people aware of what is available with the government. So currently 210 schemes of 21 departments are now available under this service. We have 7 operational citizen service centers across the state currently, and the project is fully funded by the state government. Services such as caste certificates, divergence, income certificate, residence certificates, just to name a few, including survey plans, are all available at the CSEs. And a total of 4,32,097 applications have been received and serviced till 6th of Jan 2022. Then we've also launched the common service centers by integrating the Goa Online portal with the digital seva portal, providing delivery of services through VLEs, those are village level entrepreneurs. So we've delivered 51 Goa Online services through these VLEs. We currently have 246 CSEs, VLEs operational, and a total of 11,756 transactions have been executed through these village level entrepreneurs. Our DigiLocker went live on June 2021 and we have now 421 registered users with DigiLocker currently. Then the department has also onboarded 31 services from Goa Online and integrated the Goa board, the 10th and the 12th certificate, Goa University certificates, plus 40 plus educational courses from 2011 to 2020. So the Department of Technical Education, WRD, Transport Department, Municipal Administration, Department of Excise are now also in the process, and our aim is to eliminate any need to ask the public for documents since the government itself generates all the documents. So it is no visit to no document. The government of Goa also set up public Wi-Fi by installing Wi-Fi access points in 6 villages on a pilot project in the month of November 2021. The system is being used now by students for online accessing and e-content and for attending online classes. The village panchayat commissioned under this pilot projects were Morpilla, Kotigaon, Mopa, Ogwem, to name a few. Now to come to the startup policy, 2021 was revised and notified on 11-11-21 with additional benefits for women entrepreneurs and a proposal for establishment of fund. A total of 63 startups have been certified from July 2019 to November 2021. Currently, 7 applications are under scrutiny by us. A total of 16 startups have been provided funds under the seed capital scheme and an amount of 1 crore, 7 lakhs and 40,000 has been dispersed so far. A total of 13 startups have received funds under various subsidies and schemes such as a power subsidy, internet subsidy, land lease, salary reimbursements, trademark reimbursements, etc., which amounts to 32 lakhs 52,000. Which have been dispersed. And additionally, a total of rupees 55 lakh 75,000 has been approved for disbursement of 16 startups at the 7th HPC meeting, which was held on the 6th of this month. Under the IT policy 2018, 15 IT companies have been successfully registered through 2020 and 21. 9 incentive applications also were approved for disbursement, and the amount dispersed on 8th of December 2021, these were the applications that were processed and done. A total of 25.3 lakhs have been approved for the first time disbursement in November 2021, and a total of 19,34,787 have been dispersed to the 3 applicant companies. Then we have under our wing also the Greenfield Electronics, the EMC at Tuer, which has been developed over an area of 5,97,125 square meters. So this started with an objective to promote world-class ecosystems for electronic manufacturing. So the basic infrastructure is ready. That's the road, allied utilities at the administrative block, street lighting, also the fire station, a water treatment plant is ready, and we also have the land allotment policy which has also been in place and notified in August 2021. So land allotment process is ongoing right now. Screening committees have recommended allotment of land to 3 companies right now, that is Kenkre Generators, Samnavi Digi Media, and Tangentia of India Technologies have been the ones who have been allotted land so far. Then we also have the Goa Telecom Infrastructure Policy also, which was notified in August 2020. And the policy was constituted as a single window system for installation of mobile towers so as to make connectivity better. But this will be done by the Public Works Department, who is the nodal agency for issuing license for installation of these towers. Then under the PG PMG Disha scheme, we have, which aims to transform India into a digitally empowered society as per the vision of our Honorable Prime Minister. We have about 2,731 beneficiaries certified since 2019. Then the Department of IT has also formulated a scheme to empower ST and SC communities using ICT tools through the IT Knowledge Center. This is implemented through the MS Infotech Corporation of Goa Limited, that's the ITG, under the Tribal Subplan and Scheduled Caste Subplan to provide basic computer skills to local youth, housewives, or whoever from that community wants to take up this course. Through the scheme, there are no fees payable by the ST and SC candidates, and a total of 5 agencies have been approved to operate at 7 different locations. Till date, a total of 624 ST beneficiaries and 86 SC beneficiaries have benefited from this scheme. Then we also have various COVID-related IT works, that is, you all know during the COVID times, the travel pass, the temporary passes. Then we had exclusive websites with information related to COVID. Then social media management, promotion and delivery of essential services by e-commerce. Then border vehicle management system, which was Omega, for cross-border vehicle movement. Dedicated food helplines, issuance of passes to IT and allied services. And Department of IT also organized a Startup India Global Venture Capital Summit in 2019 on the 6th and 7th of December. The Startup India Global Venture Capital Summit was a unique gathering of global fund managers, limited partners, officials from the government of India, and there were lots of path-breaking startup companies that also took part, and they showed very keen interest in Goa. Department of IT then also organized a founder boot camp in partnership with the government of Goa and a Highway to 100 Unicorns in the month of March 2020. Then the founder boot camp is a deep mentoring program. It was specially curated by Microsoft for select emerge X startups from across the country, including those selected from Goa at this event. And Department of IT also organized the Antaprerna from 29th of August to 3rd September 2021, which was a 2-day startup conclave and entrepreneurship summit in collaboration with the Atal Incubation Center and the Goa Institute of Management. And I'll come to the revenue department. So the revenue department has always been in the process of making things easier through the Goa online portal. Then citizens can now avail of these facilities, can also apply for various certificates online. Summary of very important initiatives taken recently, I will let you all know, that is the mutation process. So the department has simplified the mutation process by amending the Goa Land Revenue Code and the Indian Stamp Act and the rules whereby now the mutation fee and stamp duty can be paid online without visiting any office. Also, in direct and clear sale deed cases where the vendor has given his NOC for mutation, the mutation can be carried out in a single day without seeking any other application or any visit to any other government offices. For partition, earlier the deputy collectors used to issue notices and complete a proceedings before marking the files to ISLR. The surveyors also then used to issue notice and carry out proceedings. So to remove these duplications and to reduce the hassles to the public, the powers of the deputy collector have been delegated to ISLR. And now ISLR can decide these applications, which have greatly helped in speedy disposal of long-pending issues. Additionally, partition notices were also being displayed are being displayed on websites where any person can view the past notice and subscribe for a future one. These online services are not only transparent but then also display information for better publicity. Similarly, the powers of deputy collector to do demarcation and resurvey has been delegated to ISLR. Then the availability of survey plans in Form 1 and 14, which is now online. Citizens can now apply for copies of survey plan and Form 1 and 14 by paying the necessary fees, and also to expedite the issuance of official copies to these land record and survey plans, which are digital and computerized copies, have been made valid without any signature. If people want to check the authenticity of the same, they can cross-verify with the information which is on DSLR website. Such records now are being used immediately on realization of the necessary fees. And for information purpose, a digital copy of the survey plan in Form 1 and 14 can be downloaded from the DSLR website without any payment. In addition, also we have issued a circular to all departments that these computerized copies are valid without signature of the officer. And just recently, the DSLR website is also migrated to cloud to provide a better user experience. We've also changed the way notices are served. As discussed above, in addition to online display of notices, we have brought now the postal service into the picture, and we've engaged them to directly deliver these notices by speed post. So these notices also have a barcode, so there's a system where you can track them. So that makes it easier, so people know exactly where it has reached, and once it's delivered, you'll get a SMS to say that it's delivered and also when it's dispatched. This process eliminates the need for citizens to visit the office where they earlier had to, and it was quite difficult. Then we also have the property register. Now, our department has notified new rules for creating of a property register. The property register links the property related records of many departments, including the TCP, agriculture, registration, forest, DSLR, etc. So the property register displays the current and the live information which is collected from all other databases and which are maintained by other departments. This will help the practice of asking for NOCs from different departments. Then public will also get to know the clear picture about their property. Efforts also have been made to prepare a useful property register. Still, if any person feels that the information provided by any department is not correct as per understanding, the person can submit his comments or remarks for the same. These will be forwarded to the concerned department, and by this method, the property register will constantly improve and capture and retain better information. Then procedural involvements. Earlier, this was also a very important one, where a widow was supposed to submit an NOC from the SDM before being able to sell her property. So the revenue department has removed that need to submit such an NOC and such an NOC. So now without that, she's able to go ahead and sell her property. And we've also, earlier the process to obtain the circle rates was very lengthy. Now we have a notification in place which is modified and provides an easier process to access the circle rates. The list of cases pending in the revenue department also and the status can now be checked online through Goa Online. Other notable actions and what we have done is the Department of Revenue has amended the Indian Stamp Act 2021 to reduce the monetary burden on Goan families by reducing the existing rate of 3 to 4.5% of stamp duty to just an amount of rupees 5,000 within the defined family. So it has to be a blood relative. Then there were lots of comunidades who were financially weak. And the administrators of the comunidades were not able to make the payment to their staff. So the government has now stepped in and provided full support for the monthly payments to such comunidades. And till now, we have paid them an amount of 4 crores to different comunidades. We have also laid a foundation stone for the North Goa Collective Building. Then 22 new vehicles were handed over to Collective North and South. Those are the e-vehicles. 49 Goan families from the village of Akeba in Salsar Taluka were issued certificate of ownership sanads, which were pending for almost 56 years since the acquisition in 1964. Provisional certificates granting occupancy class 2 rights to residents of Mayam village of evacuee property were also done. Then students, the Goan OBC students used to get only provisional certificates, but now the revenue department issues final certificates to them. And also the department has cleared over 8,000 caste certificates which are pending before the caste scrutiny committee. The next gratuity payment for repairs of houses also under the Goa Disaster Management Fund scheme have been enhanced. Fully damaged houses now get about 2 lakhs for pakka house and 1 lakh for kacha houses. And partially damages also were damaged houses were increased from 250,000 for pakka houses and 25,000 for kacha houses. So this is about all that we've done. Total. Yeah. No. Total amount.
Congratulations for Madam Jennifer Munsarat and the entire team of the Revenue Department, Labor Department and IT Department. Especially Sangamunja Revenue Department atle je kaam kela with the property registered. First time government property registered ready kata. Government achi property various department akade asa. The eka platform achi hadpache kaam amcha Revenue Department an kela. जेणेकरून डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंटाची प्रॉपर्टी आज आमकां जर सोदतले जाल्यार डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंटा कडेन प्रत्येक फावटी वयचें पडटालें. त्या खातीर ती मॅडम जेनिफर एन्ड संजय कुमार ताणें जो कश्ट घेतलो आनी जें काम केलां ताज्या बद्दल खरोखरूच तांचें खूब खूब अभिनंदन. सर्वींग नोटिसीस आसतल्यो ऑनलायन प्लॅटफॉर्मार, जेणे करून जो कोण एब्रॉड रावता तांकांय बी ज्यो नोटिसीस ज्यो आसा ह्यो ऑनलायन पद्दतींत अवेलेबल जाता. हाज्या पयलीं तांचे एड्रेसीस हांगासर नाशिल्ल्या कारणान ताका मेळनाशिल्ले आनी डिफरंट केसीस ज्यो जाताल्यो पय न्ही त्यो ताका लागून जाताल्यो. आतां जरी एब्रॉड आसलो जाल्यार ऑनलायन तांच्यांनी गेल्या उपरांत तांच्यो नोटिसीस ह्यो तांकां मेळपाक शकतले. म्युट्युएशन प्रोसेस तांच्यांनी सिम्प्लिफाय केलो, पार्टिशन प्रोसेस तांच्यांनी सिम्प्लिफाय केलो, अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सर्वे प्लॅन 1 and 14 तांच्यांनी सिम्प्लिफाय केलो, सर्वींग ऑफ नोटीस सिटीजन प्रोसिजरल इम्प्रूवमेंट तांच्यांनी केलो आनी विशेष करून तांच्यांनी झोनल प्लॅन जो आसा वीच इज अवेलेबल ऑन ऑनलायन गोवा ऑनलायन पोर्टलाचेर अवेलेबल केलो. आतां पर्यंत गोवा ऑनलायन पोर्टलाचेर सर्विसीस जर पळयत जाल्यार मोर दॅन 14 lakhs ऑफ सर्विसीस, म्हणजे एकट्यान 2-2, एकट्यान 3-3, मोर दॅन 14 lakhs सर्विसीस ज्यो आसा ह्यो लोकांनी ताजो बेनिफिट्स घेतलेलो आसा. म्हणजे गोवा ऑनलायन पोर्टलाचेर वचून सर्विसीस घेतलेले आसा किंवां तांच्यांनी कॉमन सिटीजन सर्वीस सेंटराचेर वचून घेतलेलो आसा किंवां कॉमन सिटीजन सर्वीस सेंटर गव्हर्मेंट ऑफ इंडिया एन्ड गव्हर्मेंट ऑफ गोवा हाजेर तांच्यांनी हो बेनिफिट्स खूब मोठ्या प्रमाणांत फायदो घेतलेलो आसा. त्या खातीर पयल्यात पयली रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंटांतलें काम हाज्या खातीर हांव तांची खूब तोखणाय करतां. रिगार्डींग द लेबर डिपार्टमेंट, इट इज अ मॉडल करियर सेंटर आनी CII बरोबर टायप, तांच्यांनी खूब बरें काम केलां. त्याच बरोबर स्वयंपूर्ण युवा हो खूब बरी इनिशिएटिव्स घेवन तांच्यांनी जॉब, करियर, बिजनस ह्या बाबतींत जो गायडलायन्स केला, इट इज अ गूड इनिशिएटिव्स ओके बाय लेबर डिपार्टमेंट. सेकेंड, रिगार्डींग द IT डिपार्टमेंट, IT क्लस्टर जो आसा हो एक्टिवेट केलो. थंयसर 4 कंपनींक लँड अलावटूय केली आनी नाव दे हॅड ऑलरेडी फाउंडेशन स्टोन तांच्यांनी ह्या दिसांनी फाउंडेशन स्टोन घालून घातलो. ऑलरेडी 4 कंपनींनी तुवें आपलें काम जें आसा हें तुयेंत तांच्यांनी सुरवात केलें. 64 पिपल हॅव टेकन द बेनिफीट अंडर द स्टार्टअप, IT स्टार्टअपाचो फ्रॉम द 4 lakhs to 10 lakhs रुपीज पर्यंत सबसिडी दिवपाचें काम आमच्या IT डिपार्टमेंटान स्टार्टअपाच्या अंदर केलां. हांव लोनाचें सांगना, लोन तर मेळटात मेळटा, बट दीस इज द सबसिडी तांच्यांनी अवेल केल्ली आसा. त्या खातीर अशा पद्दतीचें इनोवेटीव काम आमच्या तिनूय डिपार्टमेंटांनी खूप बऱ्या पद्धतीत केला. गोवा टेलिकॉम पॉलिसी रेस्टॉल करून कनेक्टिविटी इम्प्रूवमेंट जे काम जे असा हे आयटी डिपार्टमेंटान खूप मोठ्या प्रमाणात केला. त्या खातीर हांव तेंचे अभिनंदन करता. आनी प्रॉपर्टी रजिस्टर्ड वीच इज द युनीक इन द स्टेट ऑफ गोवा. नो अदर स्टेट इज हॅविंग दीस टायप ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी रजिस्टर्ड प्लॅटफॉर्म इन देअर ओन स्टेट. सो दॅट फॉर दॅट पर्पज आय एम कॉन्ग्रेच्युलेटिंग मिस्टर संजय कुमार हू हॅज टेकन द इनिशिएटिव्ह टू फॉर्म द प्रॉपर्टी रजिस्टर्ड प्लॅटफॉर्म इन द स्टेट ऑफ गोवा. वन्स अगेन आय एम कॉन्ग्रेच्युलेटिंग द लेबर मिनिस्टर जेनिफर मोन्सेरात. अजून एक एडिशनल काम जे केला ते 2012 उपरांत फर्स्ट टाइम आम्ही कमिटी नोटिफाय केली टू रिवाइज द मिनिमम वेजीस ऍक्ट 1948. मिनिमम वेजीस ऍक्ट रिवाइज करचो म्हणून आमच्या लेबर युनियन क्रिस्टोफोर हाज्या पयली म्हाका कंटिन्युअसली म्हाका हें लेबर मिनिस्टराकूय मेळ्ळो आनी तांच्यांनी 27 जून 2012 ही कमिटी सेटअप जाल्ली. तेज्या उपरांत रिवाइज केल्ले. तेज्या उपरांत मिनिमम वेजीस आयज पर्यंत रिवाइज जावंक नासले. अनस्किलचे 307 आसा, सेमी स्किलचे 368 आसा आनी स्किल्सचे 423 आसा. हायली स्किल्सचे 465 आसा आनी क्लॅरिकल 423 आसा. ते रिवाइज जावपाची गरज आसा आनी ते रिवाइज करपा खातीर आमकां कमिटी नोटिफाय करपाक जाय आशिल्ली. अंडर द चेअरमॅनशीप ऑफ लेबर मिनिस्टर आम्ही ती रिवाइज केली. केन्ना तरी फुडल्या 1-2-3 म्हयन्या भितर हे रेट्स ही कमिटी आपले वेगवेगळे मिटींग्स वेगवेगळे असोसिएशन जवळपास ऑल टुगेदर देर आर 29 मेंबर्स फॉर दीस कमिटी. ती कमिटी मिटींग्स घेतली आनी हो रिवाइज जो आसा मिन्स आमचे वेजीस ज्यो आसा मिनिमम वेजीस स्टेटींतल्यो ह्यो रिवाइज जातल्यो जेणे करून सगळ्या लोकांक हाजो बेनिफीट जो आसा हो खूब मोठ्या प्रमाणात तांकां बेनिफिट्स मेळटलो. हाज्या रिलेटेड जर तुमकां कितें विचारपाक जाय आसत जाल्यार तुमी विचारूं येता. अदरवायज आय एम गोईंग फॉर द कोवीड रिलेटेड मॅटर. आत्ताच्या घडीक आम्ही म्हटलां ही जी आसा पळय रिलेटेड लँड सरकाराचो पोर्टल आनी हेच्या संदर्भातलो विषय आसा. डेट तो विषय वेगळो आसा. आता केन्ना तरी परत आन्सर करता. नेक्स्ट कितें म्हटलें? इवेक्यू प्रॉपर्टी मयांतलो विशय मॅडम दिता आसतना सांगलें इट इज एन आतां पर्यंत आमचे कडेन व्हेरी फ्यू केसीस आर पेंडींग. व्हेरी फ्यू जेंच्यांनी एप्लिकेशन्स 2000 सुमार लोकांनी दिल्ली. म्हाका दिसता हार्डली 300-350 एप्लिकेशन्स पेंडींग उरल्या. इट इज इन प्रोसेस. मॅक्झिमम लोकांचो पयलो इशू आशिल्लो हाऊसीस, सेकेंड इशू काउशेड्स एन्ड थर्ड इशू इज एन एग्रीकल्चर. फर्स्ट वी हॅव गिवन प्रायोरिटी फॉर द हाऊसीस. वी हॅव रिझॉल्व द हाऊसीस इशू. तांचे 3 डॉक्युमेंट सबमीट करप आनी ते कंटिन्युअसली आशिल्ले. बट मया इवेक्यू प्रॉपर्टीच्या बाबतीत पर्सनली हांव आनी रेवेन्यू मिनिस्टर हांच्यांनी लक्ष घालून मॅक्झिमम जाणांचे हे इशू रिझॉल्व जाल्ले आसा. अकॉर्डिंग टू द कोमुनिदाद ऍक्ट, जेणी जेणी कोमुनिदाद ऍक्टाच्या प्रमाणे रेग्युलरायझेशनाक अप्लाय केला, कोमुनिदाच्या कायद्या प्रमाणे तांकां जेंका रेग्युलरायझेशन दिवपाक जाय ते आमी कोमुनिदाच्या ऍक्टा प्रमाणे दिल्ले आसा. परत एकदां सांगता म्हणजे लँड एक्विजिशन जो प्रोसेस जो आसा हो वेगळो. लँड एक्वायर केल्ल्या गव्हर्मेंटान ताका आमी रिपेमेंट्स केल्ले आसा. डेट इज इशू इज वेगळो इशू आसतलो. आमी परत एकदां सांगता की जे रेट डिसायड जाल्या तेन्ना म्हणजे कदाचित 2012 पयली रेट डिसायड जाल्ले आसत जाल्यार त्या रेटी प्रमाणे तांकां मेळटले. ते आमचो थंयसर लँड एक्विजिशन ऑफिसर्स तांकां कॉपरेट करता आनी मॅक्झिमम जाणांचे इश्यूज जे आसा रिझॉल्व केला. हांवें पर्सनली मॉनिटर केला. थंयसर आमचो शेटकार इज अ लँड एक्विजिशन ऑफिसर. कोणाचे फक्त डिस्प्युटेड लँड जर आसत जाल्यार तांचे पेमेंट दिनासतना उरल्या. सिंगल विंडो क्लियरन्स तुका खंय ते डेट इज इन अंडर इंडस्ट्री आयपीबीच्या अंतर्गतचो विषय आसा. आयपीबीचो विषय आसा. वेन आय एम आन्सरींग द आयपीबी डेट टायम आन्सर यू. आलवारा लँड तुज्या म्हायती खातीर सांगता. फर्स्ट टायम आमच्या गव्हर्मेंटान जेणी प्रोसिजर कंप्लीट केला तांकां पोझिशन दिवपाक सुरवात केलें. दीस इज अ गूड इनिशिएटिव्ह टेकन बाय माय गव्हर्मेंट. आतां पर्यंत जेंच्यांनी आपलो प्रोसेस कंप्लीट केलो म्हाका दिसता 8-10 केसीस ज्यो आसा त्यो आमच्या कडल्यान केसीस तांकां सनतूय मेळिल्ले आसा. नेवर हाज्या पयलीं आलवारा लँडाक आयज पर्यंत सनत मेळूंक नाशिल्ले. 8-10 जाणांनी प्रोसिजर आपलो सगळो कंप्लीट केलो. तांकां सनत ऑलरेडी इश्यू जाल्ली. सरकारान कामा केल्या ती जनते समोर वचपाची गरज असा. पावणे तीन वर्षान सरकारान जी कामा केल्या ते नाल्या तू बरे बरोवचो ना म्हणटा, पण बरे बरोवपाक जाय. तुवेंनी लोकांक बरे दाखोवपाक जाय. जे कितले केल्ले आसा ते लोकांक दाखोवपाची गरज आसा, लोकांक सांगपाची गरज आसा. ऑल मिनिस्टर्स वील टेल, ऑल मिनिस्टर्स वील तेंचे आपलो कितें कितें काम केलां. कारण शेवटी दीस इज अ इलेक्शन गोईंग फेज. त्या खातीर फाटल्या पावणे तीन वर्सांनी आपूण जें कितें काम केल्लें आसा तें लोकां समोर वचपाक जाय. आज आय टी मिनिस्टराच्या बरोबर हांव मुद्दामून म्हणजे आय टी मिनिस्टरान रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंट इज अवर मेजर डिपार्टमेंट आनी मेजर काम रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंटांत केलां. सो डॅट अलॉंग वीथ आय टी मिनिस्टर हांवें तें एक्सप्लेन करपा खातीर मॅडमीक हांगा आपय. तें आतां हांव कशें सांगतलो तुका, कोवीड रिलेटेड. ओके, आमी कोवीड रिलेटेड राज्यांत कोविडाच्या संदर्भातल्यो केसीस डे बाय डे वाडत आसा. आनी केसीस जरी डे बाय डे वाडल्यो जाल्यार हॉस्पिटलायजेशन हें खूब कमी प्रमाणांत आसा. आमकां सगळ्या जाणांक काळजी घेवपाक जाय. आमी जशें म्हणटा की कोवीड प्रोटोकॉल हे प्रत्येकान पालन करचें. हाच्या रिलेटेड आमी 29/12/2021 ह्या दिसा जो सर्क्युलर काडला वीच इज इन फोर्स आसा, आनी तो कलेक्टर आनी पुलीस डिपार्टमेंट हेका अजुनूय बी स्ट्रिक्टली आमी फॉलो करपाक सांगलेलो आसा. आनी ताच्या रिलेटेड परत आमी टुरिजम डिपार्टमेंटान 27 December 2021 हाका ओमिक्रॉन आनी कोवीड ताच्या रिलेटेड जो सर्क्युलर काडला तोय इन प्लेस आसा, तोय स्ट्रिक्टली आमी फॉलो करपाक लायला. आनी आज फ्रॉम द हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंट एपिडेमीक एक्ट 1897 ताज्या मार्फत आमी हे सगळे इन फोर्स आसतना एक एडिशनल आमी सर्कुलर एपिडेमीक एक्ट इनवोक करता. आनी ताज्या संदर्भात फक्त एकूच तेका एड करता, वीच इज एन पब्लीक गॅदरींग शॅल बी रेस्ट्रिक्टेड टू द 50% ऑर मॅक्झिमम ऑफ द 50% ऑफ द सिटींग कॅपेसिटी फॉर इनडोर हॉल्स ऑर ऑडिटोरियम्स. आनी सेकेंड इज द मॅक्झिमम फॉर द 100 फॉर द ओपन एरिया. म्हणजे भायली पब्लीक मिटींग सुद्दां आसत जाल्यार ती 100 वयली घेवची न्ही. कसलीय पब्लीक मिटींग, कसलेंय पब्लीक गॅदरींग, कसलेंय पब्लीक फंक्शन, एनीथींग ओपन प्लेसीचेर सुद्दां 100 वयर घेवचें न्ही. आनी इनडोर हितूर सुद्दां 50% ऑफ द कॅपेसिटी किंवां मॅक्झिमम इज 100 हाज्या वयर जें आसा एट अ टायम. आमी म्हटलां एट अ टायम येवन वचून तें चड आसूं शकता, त्या खातीर तें जें आसा हें घेवचें. अदरवायज बाकी आमी इम्पोज जितके केल्ले आसा रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स सगळे बाकीच्या म्हणजे आमचो सेक्रेटरी रेवेन्यू जो अंडर डिजास्टर मॅनेजमेंटाच्या अंदर 19/12 काडला तो इन फोर्स आसा. आनी टुरिजमच्या वतीन 27 December काडलेले सर्क्युलर इन फोर्स आसा. आनी हाचे नवीन ऑर्डर जी आसा आमी हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंटाच्या वतीन आज हे जातले. सध्या तरी 26 January पर्यंत आसा. ताज्या उपरांत रिव्यू करून फुडलें डिसायड केलें वयतलें. मॅक्झिमम आमकां दिसून येयला की क्रावडेड प्लेसीस ज्या ज्या जाग्यार आसा थंयसर चड प्रमाणांत आमकां स्प्रेड जो आसा दिसून येता, त्या खातीर क्रावडेड प्लेसीसचेर रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स दवरपा खातीर हे सर्क्युलर जे आसा हे काडलेली आसा. थोड्या फाल्यांच्यान मोठ्या प्रमाणांत पुलीस कलेक्टर डिपार्टमेंट्स बाकीच्यो सगळ्यो पंचायती आनी हांकांय आमी सांगलां की तुमी मॉनिटर करचें आनी जेणे करून क्रावडेड प्लेसीस ज्यो आसा ह्यो लोकांक एकत्र येवपाक दिवचे न्ही किंवां चड मोठ्या प्रमाणांत गर्दी जी आसा करची न्ही, जेणे करून आमी पॉझिटिव्हिटी रेटाचेर कंट्रोल करपाक शकतले. आमी टेस्टींग फेसिलिटीज सगळी कडेन त्याच पद्दतीन अवेलेबल आसा. सगळ्या जाणांक हांव परत एकदां आव्हान करतां की वॅक्सिनेशन कोणी कोणी घेवंक ना तेंच्यांनी फर्स्ट डोस आनी सेकेंड डोस हे वॅक्सिनेशन खूब मोठ्या प्रमाणांत घेवचे. ओके, आनी बॉर्डरीचेर आमच्या फाटल्या सर्कुलराच्या प्रमाणे जसो आमकां अजून टेस्टींग थंयसर आमी हे करूंक ना. रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स बाकीची सगळी जी आसा इंटरनॅशनल पॅसेंजर्स नॅशनल पॅसेंजर्स एट एअरपोर्ट रेल्वे ती रेस्ट्रिक्शन सगळी लागू आसा तशीच. रिव्यू जातले, इट इज एडमिनिस्ट्रेटीव डिसिजन. हय, इंटरनॅशनल पॅसेंजर्स येतात तांकां तांची आर टी पी सी आर ही एअरपोर्टाचेर जाता. 7 days तेंच्यांनी हॉस्पिटल आपले आयसोलेशनान रावपाक जाय. 7 दिसां उपरांत परत एकदां तेंच्यांनी टेस्ट करपाक जाय. ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स जे आसा पळय न्ही तांच्यांनी कन्सर्न जांच्या कडेन जे इंटरनॅशनल पॅसेंजर आसा तांची त्या पद्दतीन रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स घालची आनी स्टेक होल्डर्सांनी त्या पद्दतीन काळजी घेवची. अदरवायज पुलीस वील एक्ट. नायट कर्फ्यू लाँग ना. आम्ही त्या खाली नाईट कर्फ्यू लावच्या ऐवजी आम्ही म्हटलेलं असं की क्राउडेड प्लेसीस जे असा पण नाही ह्यो क्राउडेड प्लेसीसचे रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स घालपा खातीर आयदर डे असू किंवा नाईट असू सगळीकडे क्राउडेड प्लेसीसचे रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स असतली. मेडिकल फेसिलिटीज वी आर फुल्ली इक्विप्ड विथ द मेडिकल फेसिलिटीज म्हणजे इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर असतले, ह्युमन रिसोर्स असतले, मग सगळीकडे आमच्या आयसोलेशना खातीर असतले किंवा हॉस्पिटलायझेशना खातीर मेडिकल फेसिलिटीज फुल्ली आमच्याकडे अवेलेबल असा. आत्ताच्या घडीक आम्ही मॉनिटर आपले लिस्टेड करून दौरल्या, आत्ता गरज ना, आम्ही सिच्युएशन रिव्ह्यू करून त्याप्रमाणे गरज लागली असत जाल्यार प्रायव्हेट हॉस्पिटल ऑनबोर्ड या प्रायव्हेट हॉस्पिटल गरज लागली जाल्यार ऑनबोर्ड घेऊन ऑन अ सिंगल डे वी कॅन पास द ऑर्डर आणि वी कॅन टेक द प्रायव्हेट हॉस्पिटल फाटले फावटी सारखे आम्ही घेऊन शकता. बीचीस आणि मार्केट प्लेसीसचेरूय जसे म्हटला पण ॲट अ टाइम एकीकडे ओपन प्लेसीचे 100 चढ लोक आसचे नाही हाची काळजी आमच्या पोलीस डिपार्टमेंट घेतले. त्या खातीर सांगला की नाईट कर्फ्यूच्या पेक्षा गॅदरिंग ज्या जाग्यार चढ जाता ताजेर रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स करप गरजेचे असा. मार्केट असतले, बाकीचे पब्लिक मिटींग्स असतल्यो, इवन दो पॉलिटिकल मिटींग्स असतल्यो, हेजेर सगळ्याचेर कंट्रोल हाडप गरजेचे असा. आम्ही म्हाका दिसता हाजेर जर कंट्रोल हाडलो इवन दो पॉलिटिकल मिटींग असू पब्लिक मिटींग असू 100 लोकांच्या वयर परमिशन्स ही फाल्यांच्यान कोणाकूच मेळची ना आणि कोणी म्हणजे इवन दो फॉर एनी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज कोणीच मिटींग घेवची न्ही आणि पब्लिक गॅदरिंगूय जी असा पहिली 100 लोकांच्या वयर ओपन प्ले ओपन स्पेसीतले सुद्धा करचे न्ही. 50% कॅपेसिटी चलता, 50% कॅपेसिटीचेर चलता. ऑलरेडी आमची रेस्ट्रिक्शन्स असा 80% कॅपेसिटीचेर चलता. चलो आज कोविड के लिए जो हमारे पहले रेस्ट्रिक्शंस थे रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंट की तरफ से जो हमने 29/12/21 को लिए रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंट से वो ऑर्डर वैसे ही इम्प्लीमेंट हो रही है. उसके बाद में टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट से 27 December 2021 की ऑर्डर थी वो भी ऑर्डर फॉलो कर रहे हैं और उसमें एपिडेमिक एक्ट हम योग कर रहे हैं कि 1897 का एपिडेमिक एक्ट के हिसाब से पब्लिक गैदरिंग शैल बी रेस्ट्रिक्टेड टू द 50% or the maximum 50% of the sitting capacity for the indoor hall or auditorium etc. and maximum of the 100 people for the open area and for the indoors also for the 50% of the capacity. Isi ki political gathering ke liye bhi open mein 100 ki capacity se hi hoga. Iske siwaye jyada permissions deputy collectors aur koi jo concern authorities usko permissions nahi denge. Schools hame bandh ke liye aisa ओके फॉर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट स्टँडर्ड टू 12th स्टँडर्ड पर्यंत आणि युनिव्हर्सिटीन जो सर्क्युलर काढला फक्त त्यांची लास्ट इयरची एक्झाम जी असा ही त्यांची ऑफलाईन असा. बाकीच्या सगळ्यो स्कूल्स हांकां एड्युकेशन डिपार्टमेंटांनी सर्क्युलर इश्यू केला, गोवा युनिव्हर्सिटीनी सर्क्युलर इश्यू केलो असा. ताज्या प्रमाणे फायनल इयरची एक्झाम्स त्यांच्यानी युनिव्हर्सिटीन ऑलरेडी डिसाईड केले असा इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द स्टुडंट. हांव युनिव्हर्सिटीकडे उलयलो कारण आणि डीएचई कडे उलयलो त्यांच्यानी सांगले फायनल इयरची एक्झाम ऑफलाईन असप गरजेचे कारण फायनल इयर पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएशनाक वता किंवा खैसरी जेव्हा जॉबाक वता त्यांना त्यांची सर्टिफिकेट आणि मार्कशीट हे जेव्हा व्हॅलिड असतात त्या खातीर ते ऑफलाईन करप गरजेचे असा. हे त्यांच्या भविष्याच्या अनुसार महत्वाचे असा. हे पळय सगळ्यो एक्झामी ह्यो ट्रान्सपरंटली एक्झामी घेतलेल्यो आसा. त्यांकां आरोप करप खूप सोपें आसा. सगळे जाण प्रत्येकाचेर आरोप करीत रावतले, कोणाकूय आरोप करप खूप सोपें जाल्लें आसा. आमच्या कन्सर्न एक्झामिनेशन जे सेंटर्स आसा त्यांच्यानी एक्झाम घेतल्या आनी आपले रिजल्ट्स लायिल्ले आसा. थँक्यू.